Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be talking on how to make a simple A-line dress. So if you have not subscribed to my channel, kindly do that and also hit the notification bell. Thank you.
So this is the fabric I'll be using for the gown. The measurements I'll be using will be in the description box. Kindly subscribe if you are new to our channel, and so our returning subscribers will say a very big thank you to you. Like, share, and comment. So this is the fabric I'll be using for the gown. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fold into four. That's the first thing I'll be doing. So this is what I have after folding into four. This is the front and this is the back piece. Remember, there is going to be a zipper or a zip at the back, so that's why we have this allowance. Your allowance may be 2 inches for the zip or 1.5 inch, depending on how you want it to be. But most of the times I use 2 inches, sometimes I go for 1 inches for it. So the next thing to do is to mark out of the full length of the gown. So it's a shoulder gown and the full length is 31 inches. So I'll be using 32 inches for the gown, or better still, 33 inches for it. I'll be using 33 inches. 31 inches is the full length of the gown, then 2 inches is for the hemming and sewing allowance. So this is at 31 inches. This is 33. Then this is the full length where the shoulder will commence from. So this is what we have. So this is the full length plus the sewing and hemming allowance. The shoulder we have here is 13. Our shoulder is 13, so divide by 2 will be giving us 6.5. We'll mark our 6.5 here. With the shoulder, we'll be able to get our armhole measurement. That's our armpit measurement. So from here, we'll mark 6.5 plus 1/2 inch, 7 down. Then her bust measurement is 25 inches, which is divided by 4 will be giving us 6.25. So 6.25 inch, make it approximately 6.5 inches. Then we'll be adding 2 inches seam allowance to it. That is 8.5. Then we'll count here. For our armhole, we are not going to leave it in this block form. We're going to make a slight curve to it. So from here, we'll make something this way. This curve. Then for our shoulder, our normal neck we'll be using is 3 inches, which is from here to here, 3 inches. Then we'll slant it by 1/2 inch, 1 inch down. Here, this is what I did here. Here, we are not needing the hip measurements, we are not using the waist measurements. All we need is from this bust point or horizontal bust length, would draw it down, just like in a free form, to the edge of the gown. So that's what we're going to do. It's just like, you can just say an inline gown, if you see it that way. So this is what we have. This is what we have. But I made a mistake somewhere. Because now I've decided to attach a pleated flea to the gown of the gown. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to subtract some inches from here, from the down part of this gown, to enable me, so that the gown will not be too big on the lady, on the little girl. So I'll be subtracting 4 inches from it. But on a normal day, you should not do it this way. It's a mistake I made. Nobody is above mistakes. Most of the times we make mistakes, but the ability for us to correct our mistakes is the main deal. So this is what I have here. So I'm stopping here. So, after cutting it down, so this is what we have. The next thing we're going to be working on is the neck area, the front and the back of the neck. So for the neck, we'll be coming down by 2 inches for the back neck. From here, we're coming down by 2 inches for the back neck. Then for the front neck, though it's not likely to be a total neck, I'll be coming down by 5 inches. So this is what we have for the front neck, and this is the back neck. This is the back, this is the front. So the next thing we do is to cut out a stripe, so I'll be able to pipe in the neck of the gown, the body, to pipe the neck and the armhole. So that's what I'm going to cut. So this, I'll be cutting out a straight line. So it's maybe 2.5 inches. But that's still, you can make it, sorry, it can be 1.5 inch, 1 inch, 2 inch, 2.5. It depends on what you want. Yeah, but I don't want the stripe to be too bold, so I'm just making a smaller stripe. Just to hem the edge of the neck, so it's not be too dirty and tattered. It's not be rough actually. So this is what we'll be using to hedge. So here, the neck area. That's the next step. So we are not piping inside, we are piping it out. So we place this here. We place the right side of the stripe. This is the rough part or the wrong side of the main body of the clothes. So this and this. Place it this way. Then we'll stitch on it. So this is what we have then. You pipe out from here. You place it this way. So this is what we have after piping. So this we did here, we also do it to the other parts of the gown. So this is the fabric, this is the front, this is the back, this is the back. So the next thing we'll be doing is we have to join these two back sides together. We match, we stitch on it, we join it together to enable us to join the shoulders. So that's what we'll do now. We'll stitch on it. That's the zipper allowance we made, we pointed out while cutting. We have to stitch on it now. So what we'll be doing now is to join the two shoulders together. This is the back, this is the front. So we have to join the two together. So you place this to this and this to this, then stitch on them. So after stitching, this is what we have. We have joined the two shoulders together to get this. So the next thing we'll be doing is to pipe the armhole, to pipe this armhole using the straps we cut out earlier on. Remember, we piped the neck, the remaining we use it to pipe the armhole or the armpits of the gown. So we have piped the armhole. I'll fight the armhole. So the next thing I'll be doing is to shape the two sides of the gown. That's the next thing to do. The piping of the armhole is just the way we, the same way we did the neck area. That's how we did it. Or that's how I did it, sorry. So the next thing to do is to shape. Yeah. Or to slim fit anyone. But generally in Nigeria we say shape. Yeah. So this is what I have. Mm-hmm. So our bust then was 25.5, which is 25 inches, which is 6.25 inch. So I'm using 6.5 approximately for the bust area. Other side is not specific. So from here, you draw it down. From here, you make it down. Then we'll use a machine to stitch on it. So after shaping, this is what I have. So the next thing I'll be doing is I'll cut out the material I'm going to attach at the base of the gown. I'm going to pleat it actually. So for me to get the exact length I'm looking for, I have to take the measurement. So I'll use it here because it will start from this point. So I have 52 inches. So that 52 inches, I'll be tying it by 3. You can also do it by times 2, but I'll do my own times 3. That's what I'm going to do. For me to get, I'm going to tie 52 times 3 to get the stripe I'll be using for the base of the gown. So since they're into pieces, well, the next thing I have to do is to join them together to form a very long stripe. Then I'll pleat. Let's join them together. So this is what we have. This is what I have. I have to attach it to the base of the gown. So on this end now, I have to place it this way and place it on the gown itself. Alright, so let's get down to sewing. It's on it. You have to place this material, the stripe, on the main fabric. So that's what I'm going to continue to do until I run all of them. So this is what we have. After attaching it, we close that place we opened in the first place. So this is what we have. So this is what we have. The next thing to do is to fix the zipper. Fix the zipper, then with the inside part of it, so that the rough edges will not show. Alright? So attach the zipper, the work is done, with the edge of the base. Because it's rough, weave it. Or if you want, you can still bend it. But for me, I'll be weaving it round.